Start my recording. Set everything up. And we're good. There we go. Hey, Zwan, Rimorha. Well, happy Halloween, everyone. Even though for me it's like the morning of the 1st of November. Did everyone have a good Halloween? My subversary. A lot of subs, yeah. I normally don't get that many resubs. Oh, Kovanyev pie! Is it pumpkin pie? Hey, Thorn! Wem Pragus? How should I? I'll call you Wem. Hi, Wem. Yeah, first time. Yeah, that's true, Buzzy. It's all different months, though. Oh, no, a lot of eights, yeah. Yeah, next month is gonna give us lots of babies. Excellent! Oh, Jackalope Jaw, thank you so much! New sub, yay! Awesome! Hey, Skylar! It's good to have you at the private stream, too. Oh, I have a glass of milk. Now you can watch me coven, so that's good. I did see it, Horner, but I don't think rhythm games are really suitable for streams. At least not. I was looking for like indie horror, spooky stuff. So, yeah, I'll keep it in mind though. Maybe some other time. Turning 18, Insomniac Gamer. You're so young. Reaching adulthood. Ooh. I am 28, so I'm 10 years older than you. Jesus, so you were born in 98? Holy shit. So young. You have your whole life ahead of you. No, I'm still young too. I feel young, at least. Yeah, I should do more Bloodborne soon, but I want to finish the Dark Souls 3 DLC first. I hope that's one more stream. Okay. Are you guys ready? Let's go. Yeah, we're good. Yeah? Are you guys ready for spooks? Yeah. New game. 8%. 9. Oh god, this is gonna take a while. That's a true horror. Oh. Space key. So this one's actually supposed to be pretty good. So we're probably starting off with the best one. Okay, that's your room. Your bed is not made. Or it is made, so that's weird. There's a flashlight on the floor there. Why? Okay. Whoa, I'm super tall. Like, my head is scraping the thing. Do I need clothing? Okay, the mouse sensitivity needs to go up. How do I get into a menu of any kind? There's no menu. Menu? Please? God, I have to, like, do this to look around, you know? Like, drag the mouse. Shit. I wish there was a menu button. Oh, I turned the light on. Wait, there can't not be a menu button. It's not escape. Backspace? Huh. Tap? Shift? Crouch? C? I can't crouch either. Okay. Okay, I guess we'll just have to do this with slow turning around. Excellent! Adian! Thank you for the resub! So many subs. Okay. You guys can even see the cursor, like, to the left of my screen. See that? That's the mouse. The Okay, this is driving me nuts. There. Ah, Swan, see you later. Oh, I can open that. But Canary, you haven't missed a thing. We just woke up and we went downstairs. So what I saw in a review that made me decide to play it was the fact that a review said it wasn't like it was PT inspired but not a total ripoff. Eight, go. Oh god, turning is so slow though. Why is there a bowl of really nasty food there? Oh, did I leave the fire on? That's a bad idea.
No way!
Whoa, Ipanda, are you fucking serious? No way! Thank you so much! Holy shit, that's a good start at the stream. Thank you so much. Oh, there's a phone. Oh, question marks. Oh, I don't know my own lock code. Maybe I'm the killer. Okay. Can I interact? Lemons. Dun dun dun! Or is it orange? How do I interact with paper? It's not E. Oh, there. P to open pause menu. Oh! Yeah! No options? Are you fucking serious? Fuck. Maybe it's in the main menu. Mary Walker. I haven't written in this journal in a while, but I thought I'd write something down. Right now, Lilith is 6 years old, while Marcus is, I think, 4. The other day, she was painting a picture, and it looked fairly abstract at first, just a blend of seemingly random shades and hues. After making dinner, I came back to find her replicating a painting we had in our kitchen. It was remarkable. I haven't told Joseph yet, but I think Lilith could end up being a very special girl. Okay. I asked her where she learned to paint that way, but she responded in a confused manner, as if all she was doing was casually playing around with paint. She managed to almost completely replicate the artwork, including even the smallest details of the piece. I'll definitely have to keep an eye on her talent. Right now, Joseph and I are both working parents. Financially, we're doing well. No real troubles, no family issues either, besides his drinking problem. Fuck. I'll finish this entry up after I cook dinner. Okay. Now, how do I get you? Master bedroom, other bedroom, living room. Look for the channel numbers. Unlock it quickly. She's watching you. Don't leave the static on for too long. It makes her ears bleed. Right now, she's upstairs waiting for you. What? Okay. Master bedroom, other bedroom, living room. So we have to turn on the TV and then. No, there is no. Oh, TV? 9-7. Okay. Can you guys. Oh, that's not ominous at all. Type in 9-7 for me. That was the last one. So, master bedroom. Fucking hell, these cords making me fucking angry. Okay, there. Okay, my shadows are creepy. Eight. Other bedroom. It must be. Wait, there was one I could open, right? Oh, this one? No. There's a key, though. Oh, I want it. It looks like a key thing I need. But it isn't, I guess. Okay. This door irritates me because it's not, like, at a straight angle. Oh, no. Wait, how did I... How do I get in there then? I feel like I need that key. Feels like I'm a stranger in this house. If I need a key. I can't even crouch. I can't do anything. How are we gonna get in the other bedroom? Oh. That was just very finicky. Wait, is this a bedroom? This counts as a bedroom? Why are you shitting me? 29. Don't leave static on. Okay, let's get into a corner. Okay. So... The game closed. I didn't even do anything. Was it supposed to close? Let's restart it. Let's look at the options first. There we go. Okay, let's try that again. Is it bloodier now?
Yeah, dude.
Oh, Tesla! 666. Spooks, happy Halloween. Happy Halloween, thank you so much. Is it? I think it's bloodier now. Let's try. No, it looks the same. But it said inspired by PT, so maybe it's like a loop thing, you know? I'm not sure yet if it was just a cheap crash or if anything was different. They'll have to show us pretty fast that something is different, so... I just saw that the Windows title is, "Let's take a quick survey." Do I still have the phone? No. If only I had the phone, then I was like, okay, it's not a loop, guys. But... Maybe now we already know the code to the phone. We can maybe try typing it in immediately. Oh, the water is on. That wasn't on before, right? Was it? I'm not sure. Those shoes. Okay, do you guys remember the code? What was it? 8897? No. What was it? I already forgot. Do you guys remember? Hey, is Jenna here? Oh, there! Happy Halloween, Jenna! Guys, I need the code, quick! Nine, 7, 8, 29. Wasn't 9, 7 the last one we found? So, 29, 8, 9, 7. Guess you're right. 9, 7, 8, 29. Oh, fuck! Okay. No. Wait. Master bedrooms first, so that was 8, right? And then the other one, so 29. And then 97. Okay. Blurry. Careful. Help me. So that's the closet, right? Yeah. Let's go. Jeez, I upped the sensitivity and this is, it's still really slow. I'll up it even more next time. Let's go to the closet. Okay. Is the game gonna crash again? This is it, right? Thank you. Is there anything different? So now what? That's kind of creepy. Okay. So what do we do? We're not supposed to look there. Too tall. I don't know what to do. Hi guys. Hello everyone. There's a hint on the phone options. Oh. Welcome to the survey. You've been chosen to represent a certain demographic that is currently being studied. Wow, that's vague. Please be honest while answering all the questions. Your cooperation and honesty is appreciated. Are you currently situated in your home?
Yes.
Are you currently employed? Well, yeah. Do you use your mobile device often? All day, every day. Did you forget your password for your mobile device? No. Was finding the password for your phone easy or hard? Easy. Is anyone with you in your house currently? My cats? Do they count? Is anyone supposed to be with you currently? No. Are you a college student? No. Do you enjoy being home alone? Yeah. Because I can work. Does it ever feel creepy when you're home alone? No, I have my cats. Have you experienced the phenomenon of feeling if you are being watched but in reality you are not? Yeah. Individuals report this phenomenon quite frequently, especially when around certain paintings, dolls, or statues. Are any of those inside your house? No. No, we seriously don't have any of that. How many televisions are in your house? Two. Please take a short break. Okay. Time until next hint. First answer the questions from the phone, then wait upstairs for the crash? Head downstairs and pick up the note in the living room. What crash? A crash of the game? Oh, we didn't pick up the note. We just picked up the phone immediately. Maybe the note's different. Eh? Okay. Good to see everyone. Thanks for showing up. Thank you. Thank you for doing Halloween with me. This note? Ah, it's the same. Okay. So what should we do? Pizza. That's a large fucking pizza. Jesus. What's up with this dirt? It is kind of spoopy, isn't it? The music's good. It's like subtle background stuff. Wait, can I turn on the lights? Oh, I can. Nice. Phone. Please take a short break. I wanna continue. Oh! Yes. Oh, yes! Yes, yes, yes. All the yes. Okay. Messages. Work. Hey, to run a remark. Are you available to work next weekend? Emma can't come in, so it will only be you and Katie. It's going to be a pretty busy weekend. She could use the extra hand. Mark Fishbach. Really? Help, please. attempt number 89,264. Ooh. Error. Address unavailable. If you're receiving this, you have been chosen to participate in a nationwide survey. We believe you are qualified to be a representative of a specific demographic group we are studying. To continue, please proceed to the survey app. Yeah, okay. I did that. Sleep. That's it.
I hear a kitty! Baby!
Okay, what do I do? I need to charge my phone. It's 18%. Maybe there's a light switch here too then. Oh. Cool. Let's turn on all the lights. Why is that in the kitchen? It's not, kitchen's not a place for clothing. Or is that just me? What the fuck is up with this corner? Oh. Why is that moving? Why are you moving? What the fuck? Is that a thing Americans do? Have their lights move? Nom 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 nom. Wait, she doesn't like the static, right? Maybe we should just leave a TV on. What do you think? Want to try? We're in a corner. Hey, is this empty now? Almost. His head hit the lights. Is that it? I thought I saw something back there. Now I'm getting paranoid. Okay, I'm done. That was my experiment. What should we do? How can we trigger the next thing? I guess we haven't been in that other bedroom again. Okay, that's totally normal too. They buttered it. They butter their lights, that's funny. Was that upstairs or downstairs? Ah! I turned you off, damn it! The angel moved. You broke something, you little bitch. It's my stuff. Don't move. I'll go stand in your spot, see how you like that. Okay. Lilith Walker began painting when she was 6 years old, local prodigy. Though only being 12, the child prodigy is able to recreate masterpieces with only rudimentary materials. The child belongs to the local Walker household. Her father, Joseph Walker, construction worker, along with Mary Walker, working as a secretary at a law firm. According to Mary and Joseph, Lilith loved to paint. Why'd the rain go away? Oh, okay, there it is. Expressed her talent early. She also stated that she practices anywhere from 5 to 10 hours a day. Wow, just to perfect her craft. Her artwork is gaining popularity as demand for her pieces and replications have skyrocketed recently. Although she enjoys painting, she also plays a variety of instruments such as the violin, piano, and cello. On top of painting, she also enjoys something. So, what's up with the statue? Don't kill me. I'm just walking. Wait, the lights went off. I turned you on, damn it. Okay. How about these? Yeah. Better. Okay, it's getting kind of spoopy. Maybe Yeah. For the next portion of the survey, we will need you to fulfill a request. We need you to check if your bathroom appliances are working, specifically the sink and light switches. Please enter the bathroom in your master bedroom and check if those appliances are working properly. Wait, I don't know. Oh, maybe here? Why? Can I move this? No? Okay. Sink? I asked Mom to get me a diary after my first painting sold. Okay, so this is the daughter. Just thought it would be nice to write down some of my thoughts. Mom and Dad want me to keep painting, but I don't know if I should. It seems like all they want to do is make money from it. This supporter came in the other day. His name is Rick Driver, and he asked us a bunch of questions. Apparently, we're going to be in an article in the local news. Mom said it would help with my publicity. I hardly even like painting. That's what I thought. Like, it's always like the story someone is really good at something, but they actually don't really want to. Whatever makes them happy, I guess. I actually like playing the violin and piano way more than painting. I mean, it's okay. It's not much something I enjoy doing that much. I just hope they include Marcus in the article. I know how much he loves writing. Marcus? Who's that? Seems like Mom and Dad barely even pay attention to him. Oh, is that your brother? Like a long-lost brother? Or an ignored brother? Maybe he hates me. Maybe if I'm lucky, I'll trip, fall down the stairs, and break my arm so I can't paint anymore. At least for a while. Oh, what did I do? I zoomed in. Okay, I can zoom in with the right mouse. Crying stops. So that was the brother crying? There's someone fucking there. The fuck am I gonna do? Should I go have a look? Isn't that insta-death? Bro? Oh. The fuck. Brother. So this is like, well, at least he got a TV. Wait, was that there before? 2 SD. Anything here? Don't think so. Okay. What do we got? Maybe the phone. Oh yeah. We need to go to the... check the sink and stuff. I didn't even. But I guess I kinda did. By getting the note. Well, it's working. Look, it's working. Okay, I did it. Continue. Yeah! Are they working properly? Yes. Did you notice anything strange? No? She heard you hide. Ah! Ah, 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 ah. Where? Closet. Here we go. Next question. Next set of questions involves her personal preference concerning music. Do you enjoy listening to music? Yeah, sort of. Do you enjoy listening to rock? Yes. Do you enjoy listening to rap? Yeah, I guess so. Do you enjoy listening to classical music? Yes. Do you remember your sister's taste in music? No. Am I the brother? Am I the creepy brother? top of being talented painter, she was also a talented violin player. Do you remember her playing any songs on violin? No. Were you ever jealous of how gifted she was? How everyone always paid attention to her? Maybe that ghost is the sister. Yeah. We have a song that you might enjoy listening to. Turn on the radio downstairs and listen to the song. Fuck. Okay. Here we go. Radio downstairs. Is it here? I guess it's in the other room. Ah, that song. Okay, that's nice. Hiding. I can't crouch. If I could, I would. Is there someone sitting in a chair, or is that just luck with the shadow? I'm listening. Why? The background music is pretty intense. Is she coming over now because she likes the music? Can't turn it off. I can't turn it off. Ah. Okay, we're listening to the whole thing. Yeah, that weird shadow, I know, right? Done now with the song. My own shadow scared me. Definitely a dude. Oh, it's done. Okay, back to creepiness. I listened to it. Oh god.
Excellent!
Oh, she's coming this way. Ah, ha, ha, ha. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Came right for me. Ha, 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 ha. Okay. Oof. Okay. Let's go into the closet. Okay, Marcus. So my sister gave me a journal, even though my mom said no. She said that after her first painting sold, mom would get her a few. She gave me one of them, so I'm kind of happy about that. Nobody really knows that I'm really into writing, beside my sister. Aww. This reporter met my family the other day after cleaning the house, taking out the trash, doing the dishes, wiping the floors clean, and sweeping up. Aww, the son has to do everything. All the broken beer glasses from Dad, I assume. And lastly, after vacuuming the house, I was excited to meet the reporter. I saw him pull into the driveway, pen and notepad in hand. As I saw him getting out of the car, my dad told me that I had to stay in my room. I tried to ask him for a reason, but he just sort of pushed me in and slammed the door shut. The door, just before closing shut, struck my nose and it started bleeding. It was really the first time I've ever seen that much blood. It tastes very metallic, as if someone took a cup of water and dropped a bunch of coins in there. I never got to meet the reporter, even though I really wanted to. So he's like the ignored son. Okay. So what are we doing now? Did you enjoy the song? Yes. Do you remember what happened to her? No. Maybe she was burned. You remember what happened to your family? No. The screaming, can you hear it? No. Have you seen her? Yes. Are you lying? No. She's watching you. Do you feel her eyes on you? No. Turn around. I'm in a corner, dude. No. Do you hear the footsteps? No. Error. Okay, this is try number 82997. Okay. Let's close these doors. What the hell? Okay. Yeah. Don't mind me. I'll just go in my corner again. Yeah. My safe zone. P. Documents. Kind of sad. I mean, I'm only 15, but mom and dad are driving this whole painting thing a little crazy. They keep asking to paint for hours and hours and hours, and that's not even something I'm passionate about. I really like playing the violin, but I'm not that great at it, but it's really fun. Yeah. Both of my parents are really pushing this painting thing. They quit both of their jobs just to pursue it because it apparently makes them a lot of money. Holy shit! Never even asked if I wanted to keep doing this. I guess I don't really have a choice right now other than to keep painting. Maybe I'll make an excuse, or maybe I'll try telling no. I wish they would pay more attention to Marcus too. He puts so much effort in everything and he does really well in school. It was Christmas the other way. At least he goes to school. We had some family over. Marcus just looked so gloomy, so alone. Nobody ever got him a Christmas present besides me anyways. It's like he doesn't even exist to anyone else. I feel terrible. Also, Dad has been drinking a lot more lately. I feel he always has had some drinks, but he's doing it more and more. He gets scary sometimes. Okay. Let's check it out. So who's this? What kind of fight did they get into? Okay, it's locked. Maybe that's good. Did something happen upstairs? Is it Marcus or Lilith? Where's Lilith's bedroom then? Because this is the office, which I can't open anymore. There you go. Oh, I got the key. Hey, I can finally pick it up. So where's her room? Is it this room? Locks. Okay, I guess it opens that door. Let's go. Oh, it's just a room? I thought it was like a basement. Don't want to be here though. Huh! Jesus. No! Don't! No! Turn off the TV! No. You're not allowed to. Okay. P. No. I hate painting. Mom and Dad want me to finish one piece a week. Ugh. It takes me anywhere from 8 to 12 hours a day for me to beat that quota, on top of going to school. I tried to tell my dad to slow things down, but he wouldn't listen. Today I tried to stand up to them. I tried telling him that I didn't have the right color of red, so I wouldn't be able to finish the painting. He called Marcus down. He grunted, so you don't have the right color of red. Oh, you could smell the alcohol from his breath. He took Marcus and he started hitting him. Until blood started to drip from his nose, eventually his lips started to tear open. He threw Marcus to the ground and continued to beat him and kick him until he was a bloody mess. He took a can of booze and poured it all over Marcus and walked off muttering something. Mom just turned a blind eye and started cleaning up the blood. Marcus sat there unconscious for a bit, but I helped him up to his room. He didn't say anything. All he did was smile. He had a wide grin on his face. I stayed with him until he fell asleep reading his book about cars. Hey.
Hey, baby. Good morning.
I can't game, though, if I'm gonna cuddle you. So I'll put you down. Yeah. Okay. Cell phone have anything to say? Mom, how are you doing? I know it must be hard for you with college, work, and taking care of Lilith. I'm at a hotel right now and I'm supposed to meet my clients tomorrow. She'll be back within a week. Stay strong. That sounds kind of nice. He watched her writhing in pain as her condition set in, knowing nothing could be done to help her. Among all her family, she loved him the most. Yet. Turn around. I'm in a corner! Haha. Okay.
Be excellent to each other.
That scared me. 1,000 viewers? What the fuck? Pucker Patrol. Are you serious? That's the highest I've ever had. Holy shit, I was so into the game, I was like, what the fuck? Holy shit, thank you. Thank you so much. I'll pause it, though. Don't want to get attacked in the meantime. Whoa, thank you, Rob. That's amazing. We got a raid. 1,000 viewers. That's a lot. Yeah. It's an invasion, yeah. That's crazy. All those emotes too, they're so amazing. Thanks. Okay. Let's get back to spoops. Thank you, Rob. Thank you. Okay. Thanks for the follows. Oh yeah. That angel's still there. Jesus, fuck, I forgot. Should we... What the hell is this shed anyway? Or shed, like, room? Does this... Do we have to, like, put them in the right order? You guys want to take notes? So, 6 is EA. Eight is G-O, so that means the 8 one comes after. Oh! She's still there. Okay. 2 is SD. Okay, you stay there, lady. I can't find anyone anything else. Okay. Wait. Okay. Let's go say hi. Yeah. Okay, she's in the closet.
You gotta come out of the closet.
Okay. Whoa, thanks for the follows. Oh, she's gone. Okay. Just a note. No, don't. Leave me the fuck alone. Death of 2 siblings. 2 bodies were recovered after a fire erupted. Then who am I? The dad? Oh, fuck. Inside a suburban house near a local elementary school, the fire apparently started late at night as neighbors were the ones to report the incident. Names have not been released, but the victims were identified to be a brother and a sister in their late teens. 2 were home alone while their mother was on a business trip. The brother was going to high school and also worked a part-time job at a grocery. He did? How the fire started is not clear, but authorities have not ruled out foul play. According to investigators, a candle that was knocked over could have caused the tragedy. Officials have not ruled out foul play as a cause, but aren't suspicious of it due to the circumstances of the situation. Okay. Whoa, music's just gotten really intense. Why? So wait, who are we? Wait, you're wearing pants! Okay. Am I dead? Oh! That's very PT inspired, yeah. 3, 9, 2, 6, 4? 8. 8, 9, 2, 6, 4. Okay. I can't put it in my phone. Or unless there's nothing locked or anything.
8, 9, 2, 6.
What's this?
4.
But this is 829
eight,
and this is 892.
9, 2, 6, 4. 8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
Okay.
8, 9.
What are we gonna do?
6.
I left everything open. That's the same. That didn't change. Phew, man. Okay, I'm stressed. Okay, everything is still the same. Unless only the angel thingy is gone, I guess. It's gone. It's not here either. It's totally gone. Okay. So what happened to us? We just set it on fire because we didn't want to live like that anymore? Did we kill ourselves? What should we do? Whew, that dude scared me. This is still locked. That's probably like the final room, I guess. Is my phone telling me what to do? No. They don't want to do a survey anymore. Hmm. Closet? Empty? What does it want us to do?
8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
Can't open this. Wait, did I leave that close?
9, 2, 6,
I didn't check. I woke up in the bed.
8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
The light is water now. Guess there's something going on in the bathroom.
8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
Oh, I did that? I turned that on through the wall.
9, 2, 6, 4.
Okay.
8, 9. 8, 9, 2.
Where can we put in that code? 8, 9, 2, 6, 4. Go to letters around the house. So 8 first, go. What was 9, 2 then? The 2 was the SD, right? There's one here too. 9? 89264. So go de two is upstairs. Go dis d. Find the okay. Where did we find the EA plaque? Okay, maybe it's somewhere. It should be somewhere. So that room has one. Well, the AD must be in this room then, right?
9, 2, 6, 4, 8, 9, 2, 6.
And I don't see any plaques here.
8, 9, 2.
Hmm.
8, 9, 2, 6, 4, 8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
Wait.
8.
I want to close
nine,
this door.
Two,
I can't.
6, 4.
There might be. Nah, it doesn't look like it.
8, 9, 2.
Okay.
6, 4.
Check your phone.
8, 9, 2, 6, 4. 8, 9, 2, 6, 4. 8, 9, 2, 6, 4. 8, 9, 2, 6, 4. 8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
Can I turn it off? No.
8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
The A is downstairs where the angel spooked you.
Eight,
oh.
Nine.
Is that it? Was this one? No. Oh, here. This is 6. Oh! Oh, I need to interact with them. Oh, okay. Okay, let's do that. So it's very PT. I wouldn't say PT inspired. It's really PT-ish. But I mean, I don't mind. I'm very spooked. Okay. That was downstairs.
8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
Okay. Did we do it?
9, 2, 6, 4.
Did I miss one?
8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
8, 9, 2, 6. So we did 4, right?
8, 9.
Oh, you have to do it in order? Probably.
8, 9, 2.
Okay, let's do that. No, it's gone. I don't have to do it in order. Oh, maybe I do. 8. There is force right there by the frames on the staircase balcony. Really? Wait. Where? Oh! Is it up there? Oh! There it is! So, wait. Okay, I think we need to do them in order.
8, 9, 2, 6.
Okay. 8. This was 9, right? two is upstairs. Okay, two. Wait, where'd it go? Wasn't it here? I thought it was here. You didn't learn about Roman numerals in school, Fritz?
Where? Yeah, come. Come to me.
Kitty was on the table. What should
eight,
we do?
Nine,
you have an
two,
idea?
Six, four, eight, nine, two, six, four.
Oh, okay, Fritz. Eight, that's good.
Nine,
then.
Two, six, four.
Kitty. It's like, Mommy, nine, you have to two, give me more attention.
Six, four,
you're not giving me all your loving.
Eight, nine, two, six,
yeah.
Four.
Love you too, baby.
8, 9, 2, 6, 4. 8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
So what should we do, guys?
8, 9, 2, 6.
In the closet.
8, 9, 2, 6, 4. 8, 9.
Yeah, she's cute, isn't she? Ah! Don't lick my nose!
6, 4, 8, 9.
I love when she gives me
six,
those, like, little.
Four,
she gives me those little headbutts.
8, 9, 2, 6.
Go shit.
4. 8, 9, 2, 6, 4.
I fear the one in the bedroom might be bugged. Oh, it's back! Should we just start over again then? Just to be safe, now it's there.
8, 9, 2,
maybe it reset. Yeah, I think it reset. Okay. Don't know how, but okay. 8. Okay. 9. Two, 6, 4. That chair scared me.
Nine,
so that's the last
six,
one, yeah.
Four.
I'm sure that door's gonna open to the other bedroom. As in the 2, 6. Yeah, I knew it! I knew it! So, give it to me. Oh, this is where she needed to. There's no bed, though. Can I close this? I can't, but how can I. Oh. Oh, kitty. Yeah. Okay. Did it stop? I'm just gonna read this first, okay? I can't move. Today, I woke up and I can't really explain it, but my right hip just feels extremely stiff. I tried to get out of bed, but I can barely turn my body without feeling pain. My parents took me to the hospital just in case it was severe or life-threatening, but the staff seemed to be clueless as to what I actually have. They say they will need to complete further x-rays, possibly even use an MRI in order to verify this diagnosis. Hopefully I won't have to pain or anything. I also had a really weird dream. I was alone in the house with Marcus, but for some reason he was always afraid of me. Every time I would try to get close to him, he would run away in fear. Haha. It was such a weird dream, because in a way, it felt like it lasted forever. Okay. Oh. Did these all fall down? Oh! Oh, hi! Don't! That painting! Jesus! It's that painting, it's crying! Ugh, creepy. Nah. Oh. Oh. She smashed up this place. What? Something changed. She's standing there. I want to read! Let me read first. My parents took Lilith to the hospital after my sister said she felt immobile around her hip. She said it felt completely stiff, as if all of the muscles surrounding her hip had turned to bone. The other day, Dad threw me down the stairs because Lilith's paintings weren't selling as much as they used to. He thought it was an entertaining way to encourage her to paint better, as he phrased it. I dislocated my shoulder on the way down. After repositioning the joint back to the socket, I made a sling with some old rags I found in the closet. Still stings, but it should heal within a few weeks to a couple months. School isn't too bad. I'm working on this little project with some of my friends, trying to create our own braking system for a car, something that can be controlled remotely. I wonder if I can reverse engineer it to do the opposite task and maybe cancel the braking system remotely. Ooh, are you gonna have your parents have an accident? As long as I don't have to stay home, right? To the Walker family. We had some difficulty in regards to diagnosing your daughter's specific condition, but we have concluded that it's fibrodysplasia, a syphiscus progressiva. It is very rare but severe condition where the patient's soft tissue, when repaired, becomes ossified, basically turning into bone. This is due to a mutation in the repair mechanism of the body that results in this condition. There are treatment options to slow down the process of the condition, but I admit the future looks fairly grim. In all honesty, this is what will eventually happen. The disease will spread throughout her body until most of her soft tissue, including tendons, ligaments, and even muscle, will become ossified. The most we can do is provide medication in order to relieve the pain. Other than that, the condition has always been fatal. Your daughter might be able to make it to the age of 40 if she's lucky. Please let us know what direction you would like to take. Okay, so then everything went to shit. Okay, let's go check her out. Oh, she's gone now? Shit. Did I miss my chance? Is she back in her room? That's fucking, so creepy. The light's on there. Did I do that? Guess I did. What should we do? Oh, Kelly! Sorry to see you go again, then. It's a pretty spooky game. Maybe the phone knows something? Part 2? He had a taunting grin on his face as seeing her suffer filled his heart with delight. For the first time in a long time, he felt joy. Did we read that one? I want to do another survey. What do you guys think we should do? Examine the face painting? I can't. There's nothing to... There's no interaction thing. Maybe the door? No. Sure hope we didn't miss our chance by not... by reading the notes and not going to her. Oh, the SD's here now. So it falls down... it falls down the floor to here. Night, Sarah. See you later. Don't really know what to do, honestly. Something written there, but... Whoa. Flashlight took a long time to catch up. There was a board with some words written on it in the art room. Okay, let's check it out. Oh, this? The screaming, the crying, can you hear it too? For eternity I've lived, and for one more I shall live on. Trapped inside these memories with the devil himself. That's blood. Oh. I don't know. TV in the end of the corner. What this?
According to a recent poll, infidelity is at an all-time high. This may be due to marrying too young, lack of commitment, or even financial instability. Let us examine the story of Joseph and Mary Walker, the two married and bore a daughter Lilith, who was very talented in many artistic mediums, especially in painting. Joseph and Mary also had a son named Marcus. Joseph worked as a construction worker, while Mary worked as a secretary for a local business. Soon after discovering Lilith's talents, her parents encouraged her greatly to continue and perfect her skills. Eventually, a high enough demand for her paintings allowed the Walkers to become financially stable, simply by selling Lilith's art. Both Joseph and Mary quit their jobs, as Lilith's paintings sold anywhere from $5,000 to $15,000 a piece, depending on the buyer.
And then one a week?
Due to this high demand, Joseph and Mary began to live life far above their means, taking advantage of their gifted child in order to satisfy their own greed. It started off with Joseph burning Marcus with cigarettes if Lilith refused to work. Slowly, the abuse became worse and more intense, until one episode landed Marcus in the hospital.
Oh.
Marcus had several bruises along with a dislocated arm. The family was forced to cover up the incident and no charges were filed. This abuse continued for a long time. Marcus grew accustomed to it. It was simply a part of his life, financial hardships. Joseph wasn't able to find work due to his alcoholism, but Mary was able to find a job at her old company. Her former employer kept in touch with her throughout the years. Tension began to build within the family. Marcus usually remained passive among family affairs, but the situation gave him much joy. They were suffering, and he knew it. He couldn't have been happier. 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 He couldn't have been happier.
Can I go now? So we want to go listen to the TVs? I can't go. I'm super happy. Yeah. Someone open it for me? No. Hello? Closet? I can't close it though. Oh yeah, I can. Everyone's like, hide, hide. She stomped off to somewhere. Left a note. Don't mind me. Close the door. Close it. I can't close it. Well, let's do this then. Okay. My parents gave me the news. So I have this condition called fibrodysplasia. Basically, it's a condition where my soft tissue gradually turns into bone. They said that eventually I'll lose mobility in my arms, legs, neck, everywhere until I'll need a caretaker to basically do everything for me. Right now, I feel it in my arms and torso. For now, I just sort of stay in bed. It hurts to walk around and I can't really exercise or damage my body in any way or else it'll speed up the process. I mean, I'm only 15, so this is a lot to take in, knowing that I'll slowly become more and more immobile. It's a bit ironic, isn't it, that I wish I could stop painting or that I wouldn't have to anymore, and this was the answer I received. Ugh. The best they could do was prescribe medication for the pain. A year from now, there's a good chance I will be able to walk. And I'll be in a wheelchair or worse. I just hope my body, my family will be stable without my help. I'll be a pretty big burden. The other day I overheard my parents arguing. My mom brought up the idea of getting a divorce. I feel like this is all my fault. No, you just have really shitty parents. Okay. Can I turn off the TV? No. So, you guys want to do another TV? No story for this one? Okay. Did I just hear a thing? Face is still there. Right there. Okay. I overheard them talking about what Lilith's condition was. Apparently she has some sort of bone disorder. Basically her body keeps... Process can take a while, but it continually gets worse. Lilith won't be able to paint. I wonder what will happen. I've never seen them argue like that. It was quite entertaining seeing them bicker and yell. had a wide grin across my face as I watched the spectacle. My parents have been trying to find work ever since they heard the news, but only my mom has been able to find a job with her old employer. That hasn't had any luck. This is quite an unfortunate situation. I did a bit more research on the condition, and it seems incurable. Parents seem like they're in a state of panic. I've never seen them like this before. Frantic, scared, and unstable. I've never been more excited in my life. He's like, yes, you will go down. Okay. So we gotta find notes, I guess. Okay. The question mark's nice, at least. That face. Oh, there. My mom showed him the divorce paperwork and he was livid. I've never seen my dad this furious, his bloodshot eyes trembling in fear because he knew he was powerless against her decision. He kept taking beer bottles and smashing them against the kitchen table after he heard the news. She said she was tired of having him just drinking all day and not contributing to the family at all. I left a little surprise for him in the car. We'll find out while he's driving. Oh! For now, I guess it'll just be Mom, Lilith, and I. She asked me to get a part-time job, since we'll need the money to help with Lilith's medical bills. I don't mind working, even though I'm still in high school. I'll be pretty busy, but I guess I'll just have to deal with it. It'll be hard, though. I went to the doctor the other day and he examined my shoulder. Turns out I've had a torn rotator cuff for a while now. I've never been able to get it checked out because of my dad. I haven't been able to rotate my arm past 90 degrees without feeling this tearing sensation. Thanks, Dad, I guess. In the end, everybody gets what they deserve. Go, go, go. I'm so fucking slow. So fucking slow! No! Oh, jeez. The game was like, don't you move. You're here to spectate this. Okay. Oh, there's another one. Is there one here as well? No. Okay. No music. I don't want to. It's been hard last year. I've been working overtime almost every week at my job ever since the divorce, just to cover everything. Lilith, well, she was bedridden and relied on Marcus for just about everything. Marcus was attending college and working at the same time. I went on a business trip for about a week and I didn't get news until I came home. The house caught fire. I was told that Lilith died a horrific death, burning alive as the flames consumed her. They said the fire started in her room, most likely a candle that was tipped over. The neighbors, they said all they heard was a haunting scream, like an animal that knows its death is approaching. Everything is gone. My kids, my house. Did I deserve this? I was so blinded by greed. I'm a horrible person. Yes, you are. I let my son be abused for years just to force my daughter to paint and make myself money. I guess Joseph got what was coming to him, but now it's my turn. I just wish I could watch over them. Maybe it's the mom. No, I think it's the daughter. Where haven't we had a note yet? Oh, guess I'm not going upstairs. I want to. Get out of my way, freaking angel. Guess I'm staying downstairs. Oh,
excellent, Julie.
Holy shit. Minx just scared the shit out of me, and Chrism. Oh. Thank you so much for the host. Okay, what the fuck are we gonna do? So we have the music track. There's an angel blocking the stairs. Is she? Yeah, she still is.
I'm Joseph, back with an update concerning our latest story. A drunk driver was recently killed in an accident outside a local liquor store. According to friends and family, the man had been going through a divorce with his wife. Probably trying to drink his sorrows away, he swerved off the road, crashing his car into a tree. Officers have noted that there might have been tampering involved with the braking system of the vehicle. Fortunately, the individual suffered greatly while dying. I know a certain someone that would be happy to know so. Don't worry, I'm stuck as well. This was Joseph, bringing the local news.
Who's Joseph? Is the dad Joseph? Okay. Oh, now I'm getting the auto hosts. Thank you, guys. Oh, we can go upstairs again. That's just you. Okay. Oh! I see you. Why are you so fucking creepy? Are you gonna come my way? Should I come your way? Should I try to avoid her? I guess I'll just gonna say hi. Oh, she's gone. Shit. Oh, fuck. Then what am I doing here? Oh, hey. Ugh, don't. Okay, closet. Closet time. Bye. Bye, world. Wait. Someone's playing piano. Oh. Where is this? I don't recognize it. Is it downstairs or upstairs? Is it here? Yeah. Oh, it is. No, wait. Oh, Jesus. Where is it? Is she going down the hall? Oh, it's the staircase. It's the pillars of the... So I'm in the room to the left. Oh god. Oh god. just no. She's coming this way. She's in here. I think it's safe when the music stops. I don't know if you guys can hear it, it's really soft, but there's a piano playing in the background. It's gone now. Think I'm safe?
Excellent!
Patrick! Yay! Don't worry. Thanks for the resub. Thank you so much. I think I'm good. I don't hear her either, so... I want to close this door. Okay. Let's read that file now. Yeah? It's been almost a year since I've been diagnosed. Gotten worse recently. Losing control of hands, so it's getting difficult to write. It's a bit horrifying having all of your muscles slowly turn into bone. Marcus has been taking care of me. I feel like I'm such a burden to him. Top of school, part-time job, and taking care of me. He seems so busy. We have insurance, but we still have some money left from my paintings, but I'm still getting pretty tough to pay for everything. I can't walk anymore, so I'm pretty much confined to my bed most of the time. My favorite part of the day is when my brother comes in to check on me. Hopefully he'll never read this. This is embarrassing, but I feel like I'm holding him back. After Dad died, he just seemed so much more alive. I guess he got what he deserved. But is this my punishment too? Ooh. Okay. She pooped out another note. Nope. 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 Not doing this. Nope. Wait, it's the music again. I think it's coming from here. Yeah. It's coming from her room. Let's read the note first. I can barely keep up with everything. I was accepted into a university that I really wanted to attend, but I decided not to go through with it. Sorry. Don't mind me. Decided to attend this community college first and then transfer to university afterwards to save money. I won't be in a ton of debt after I graduate, so that'll be nice. Okay, I still need to finish reading this thing. Fuck. Last night I saw something a bit disturbing. As I made my way to my room, Lilith's door was slightly ajar, and I could also hear this high-pitched scraping sound. It was my sister scraping her nails against the wall. Turned the light on, and there was blood covering her hand. She was running the tips of her fingers across the wall up to the point where her fingernails were now loosely attached to her finger. She seemed so out of touch with reality, I looked at her other hand, but it was bent at an awkward position, her wrist bending towards her body, while her fingers looked stiff. This thing in my house, I don't think this was my sister. My sister was a painter, a talented girl with immense potential. Her eyes gradually turned towards me. I felt them almost reaching out to me, pleading for comfort. I gave her none. So maybe the brother just ended it all? Because he didn't see a way out? Eh! Why is it red? Why did it turn red? I want to read the note though. Ah, it's really long. Oh, is it on fire? Is that the idea? Okay, there's another note, so let me read this then. Mom is leaving for about a week, she's going to visit her, check on her briefly, twice a day. I forget to check throughout the week though. Sister Chore taking care of her. Why can't she just die already? Jesus Christ, am I wrong for saying that because of her talent? It destroyed our family. I wonder what my end will have in store. Who knows, maybe I'll get the worst ending of them all. I realize that my hatred for her is wrong and unjustified. It wasn't her fault she was born with that skill. I feel guilty that I enjoy hearing and seeing her in pain. It's an immature reaction for so long, I wished for someone else to feel my suffering. I would get beatings almost every week with my mom and sister just watching. It was almost entertaining thinking of what I could tell people at school when they asked about the cuts and bruises. Now it's a little different, I guess. I'm in control and she's the helpless one. I don't really believe in heaven or hell, but if one exists, I'll probably end up in the latter. Okay. Okay. I think it's fire, yeah. This will be the last letter I write. I can feel my right hand becoming immobile and stiff. Mom left a couple days ago, and it's been up to Marcus to take care of me. Even though his visits have been getting shorter and less frequent over the last months, I understand. I'm just a burden to him and my mom. He hasn't checked up on me ever since she left. I've tried everything, knocking and banging my hands against the wall, screaming. I mean, that's all I can really do since I'm practically immobile. Sometimes I get my hopes up hearing him walk up the stairs, just maybe he'll walk through the door and check on me. Did I deserve this for not standing up to my parents and letting all of this happen? It's my fault. I'm sorry, Marcus. Okay. Where should we go? We knew that from the notes. Should we try the front door? Hasn't worked so far, but... Well, the clothing is still neat. Oh, I can hear the piano music. Does that mean she's close? Where is she? This is tense. Wait, did we close this one? TV still works. Maybe it is the painting now. Wait, did the things reset? Oh. See, you can hear the piano here. Gwendolyn. The piano is definitely there. Okay, what are we gonna do? Turned it off. Oh, I'm slow. She's coming. Yeah. There's nothing I can do. Come for me. Hey, sis. Maybe that's why she's walking so weirdly. Because she's like half stiff, so she's like, ugh. What? We're still going? I thought that was gonna be the end. Now everything's gonna be back to normal, isn't it? No, it isn't. Huh. Let's read it. This must be the last one then. Life's pretty quiet, to be honest, right now. Between school, work, a bit stressful, but it's not as bad as before. Mom is set to come home in a few days. It's nice having the house to myself for about a week. I'll admit, sometimes it gets eerily quiet, and sometimes I hear these soft knocks coming from the wall. Other times I hear crying, sobbing, sometimes even screaming. It usually doesn't last too long, but still.
Both bodies were recovered, though the young woman was dead at the scene. After performing an autopsy, it was confirmed that the fire led to her death, but officials also found something strange. Her body was starving. What officials think occurred was during her final moments, as an act of desperation, she lit a candle inside her room and started the fire herself.
She was starving?
Her younger brother, Marcus Walker, might have neglected her to such a degree. She chose to end her life to ease her suffering. Emotions ranging from jealousy, hatred, enviousness, and frustration might have drove him to neglect her, despite her cries for help. Due to her rare disorder, she was extremely immobile and required help for the simplest activities. She required Marcus for everything. Marcus might have held animosity towards her, as for almost his whole life, everyone had paid their attention to her. Perhaps Marcus wanted her to feel isolated and alone, an emotion he was very familiar with. He wanted vengeance for a crime she didn't commit. Marcus's body was mostly unharmed, though he was not conscious at the scene. He was taken to a local hospital, where he currently resides.
Wait, he survived?
He is currently in a coma induced by smoke inhalation and has been unconscious ever since the fire.
Oh, I'm stuck in the house in a
coma.
No
one knows when, or if, he will ever wake up, or what he is experiencing. He could be experiencing nothing at all, or he might be suffering. The only living relative he had was his mother, Mary Walker, who committed suicide shortly after she heard about the incident. His father, Joseph Walker, was killed in a suspicious road incident where his brakes stopped working while driving under the influence.
Yeah.
Due to his unusual situation, no one is left to decide whether or not they should keep him alive in his coma. Many may wonder whether he regrets his actions. Whether he regrets neglecting his sister, starving her, and psychologically torturing her to the point of suicide. Others speculate that years of domestic abuse by his father Joseph, along with neglect from his family, left him psychologically scarred. Whatever the case may be, he tortured and isolated his sister. His sister, who loved him, and did everything necessary to protect him. Hopefully all members of the family get what they deserve. In Marcus's case, he's stuck in his own personal purgatory. Stuck in a place between life and death, an eternity of suffering awaits him. Thank you for listening. This was Joseph Walker, bringing your local news.
That's why it's like... attempt number... Jesus! No, I didn't. I haven't had time to read the note yet. No. No, I haven't read it yet. No. 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 Strange dream the other day. I woke up in this house. I was alone. After waking, so many times, horrified. Smell something burning. Okay. It's his own purgatory. That's so good. Good story. Yeah, that was really good. Good scares as well. Even though the modeling was kind of like, was very, very indie. He hadn't really done the walking of the ghost properly, I guess. But it's really hard to do, for sure. Oh, it was good. Man, that was good. Good start, right? Of the Halloween stream. How long did that take? An hour and a half? Okay. Yeah, I finished reading it. Yeah, it was a good game. Good start. Okay. Let me see. Let's see if I can exit my game. So here comes the Steam thing.